In this tutorial, we're going to cover Revit camera sections, and by that I mean we're going to use the Revit Section Box tool, but we're going to use it from a camera view instead of the default 3D view. This is a great way to show off your project. It's a really simple process to create some compelling imagery. The image here on this screen you can create in just a few minutes, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you exactly how. One quick note, a lot of the shortcuts I'm using in this tutorial are custom, but you can download them for free with a printable cheat sheet on hyperfinearchitecture.com. Get both of those on the free Revit resources page, and while you're there, check out the tutorials page for more free Revit tutorials and the courses page for professional architecture courses. The house in this video is part of that professional architecture training course. If you want to learn how to build a house and how to do it in Revit, you will really get a lot out of that. Let's get started with this one. So I'm going to go to my first floor plan, and I'm going to come up here to the little house icon, hit the arrow to drop down, and select camera. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag it out here, and you can't see it anymore because it's outside the crop boundary, which is hidden. But if I just click and hold down and drag, you can see the extents, the left and right extents of what this camera's going to see. And I'm just going to let go and click again. And so I've created my camera. Now I can play with the crop boundaries. And I'm going to hold down Shift and the center mouse button to just scroll around a little bit to change the angle to something a little bit better, something I like a little bit more. I'm going to keep changing this crop boundary till I get what I want. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to turn on the section box. And you can see it's very difficult to control, to see even the extents of it when you're in the 3D camera. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to close all the views except for this active one. That's CZ. Then I'm going to hit 3-3 to launch my default 3D view. And then if I hit WT, it'll tile. So I can see both of the windows next to each other. And what I'm going to do is when I'm in this window with the camera, if I select the section box, you can see it becomes selectable over here in the 3D view. And so this makes it a lot easier to control the extents of where it's going to go. So I'm just going to start dragging, and you can see as I'm dragging in this window on the left, it's really the section box for this. So I think that's pretty good. You can also go to the top view, hit RO, and rotate it just a little bit, see if that looks any better. I think this is fine. So if I hit, I think it's TV, I'm going to enlarge this one again. And so what I want to do now is start to work on the graphics a little bit. The first thing I want to do is I'm going to set the detail level to coarse, because I don't want to see these wall level, you know, these wall layers which we needed for our construction documents. I don't want to see them in this view, so I'm going to set them to coarse. You can see that immediately turned everything to this melon color. Alright, and the reason it did that is because Revit at the coarse detail level is going to poche anything that gets cut through. So if you open up your material settings, I have a shortcut, M comma, and you type in poche, you'll see a material that's poche. And so I've set mine to this melon color that I like to use. And so basically what you want to do is, if yours isn't already set up like this, set the pattern to be solid fill, which will be the first one, and set the color to be whatever you want. As a note, if you have colors that you use all the time and you want to save them, just click on one of the empty boxes down here. Then after you select your color, just hit add, and now it'll be locked in here. You can use that all the time. So I'm going to keep it to these melon colors that I like. If yours is not set up to poche, you can always go to Visibility Graphics and change things here. So I hit VG for Visibility Graphics. I just hit WA to quickly come down to walls. And if you go to the cut, you can override the pattern to solid, and you can override the color to something else. And that should work. I don't want to do that. I like this melon color. But one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the color of the topo. So if I select that topography, right click, and do override graphics and view by category, this is the same thing as opening up my visibility graphics. I just got to it a different way. I'm going to change the cut pattern to this earth fill, and I'm going to change the color to my dark navy, and I'm going to change the background to the solid fill, and I'm going to make the color a pretty light gray. Right, and that's how that's going to look. So the next thing we want to do is I'm just going to turn on consistent colors. I'm going to come up to graphic display options. I'm going to change the background to gradient. I like the default Revit colors, but you can always change the sky, the horizon, and the ground color if you want. I'm going to hit apply. What apply means is basically make the change and keep the window open. If I hit OK, it would have made the change and then closed the window. You can also turn on sketchy lines, enable those, and these are pretty strong, so I wouldn't go too high on those. You can see what they did. It just sort of adds a little bit of sketchiness to it. And then the only other thing really that we want to do to complete this is I'm going to turn on shadows right here. And if you click, so that button is the shadows. This button right here is the sun settings. So you can change the azimuth, which is the angle of the sun, or the altitude, which is the height. There should be some presets. So a lot of times just having the sun come from the top left or the top right will make the image look pretty good. All right, one quick correction I want to make is you can see there's a lot of poche showing in this wall, and the reason is that the section box is cutting parallel through that wall, and you never want to cut parallel with the wall in section, even if it's just a schematic design section. So unfortunately, I hid the section box. What I can always do is click the light bulb, and there I can see the section box again. So if I select it and repeat that process from before, so I hit WT, I'm going to come into my 3D view, and if I just pull that section box out a little bit, you can see it was cutting through that wall. Now it's no longer cutting through that wall, so everything is sort of cutting through more perpendicular, which is what we want. So I'll close the toggle reveal. I'll bring this up, and that should do it. If you found this helpful, please hit like, and definitely subscribe if you want to keep up to date on more free Revit tutorials as I get them recorded. Thanks for watching.